Hello everybody, this is Gunther speaking from cinema5d.com and today we are going to take a closer look at the Zcam E2C from the Chinese cinema camera manufacturer Zcam. But before we start, let's have a look at some sample footage that I shot in the beautiful town of Hallstatt in Austria. Now let's have a look at some features of this cam. It has a smaller form factor than its sister camera, the Zcam E2 flagship camera. But it has a lot of the same features. For instance, it offers multicam synchronization. It is a very economic offering. For about twice the price of a GoPro Hero 7, it offers 10-bit 4K in very advanced codecs like H.265, H.264, but it also offers ProRes recording via USB-C. And it has a flat Z-Log 2 picture profile available. But keep in mind that you have to rig up the camera with a monitor. For this purpose, it has all the mounting options that you could wish for. It also uses very inexpensive SD cards, so media costs are not going to be high with this cam. The camera Wi-Fi with the included antenna allows you to preview the image on your smartphone with the Zcam app. But now let's talk about some weaknesses of this cam. It has not inherited the very nice out-of-the-box color science of the Zcam E2 camera. Skin tones are yellowish and you have to tweak the image to get nice results. It has a very pronounced rolling shutter. It's got 36 milliseconds of rolling shutter in 4K 10-bit 25 frames per second, which is the largest rolling shutter I've ever measured. So handheld is going to be very problematic. There are no high frame rate modes. It maxes out at 4K 30 frames per second. Also, the dynamic range is very limited. The noise floor is cut off. However, looking at the waveform, it shows about 10 stops dynamic range. So who is it for? That question leaves me a bit puzzled. For a lockdown synced multicam scenario, which is not demanding in terms of dynamic range, it might work very well. But if you intend to use it as your main cinema camera, I cannot recommend it, unfortunately. So let us know what you think in the comments below. Thank you and see you soon at cinema5d.com.